Hi everyone, it's Rebecca with Stamp by the Beach, and I was going to show you today how I made these watercolor backgrounds on these cards. I just love how this color just plays on the paper and you get those geometric shapes, and there's some sparkle, and sparkle makes everything better. But I just thought these were really, really cool. I'm going to set those guys aside. So you're going to need some cling wrap, saran wrap, whatever you call it in your house. You're going to need your re-inker colors. I used Balmy Blue, Pacific Point, and Night of Navy. And then you're also going to need some shimmer paint, and I'm using the Champagne Mist. Alrighty. And then the paper that I'm using today is the Shimmer White, and I have this cut down to 3¾ by 5. I like the Shimmer White for doing anything that I'm going to put a lot of color or a lot of water type things on it, because it doesn't wrinkle up and it doesn't seep through quite as fast as the regular white. You can also use the watercolor paper, and I'll show you what it looks like on there too, because it's a little bit different. The different papers soak up the liquid a little bit differently. Alrighty, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take our saran wrap and we're just going to put it down. I'm gonna put it where you guys can see it. Okay, and you wanna think about the size of paper that you're using, because if you go crazy and get everything all over the edges, you're going to make a big mess. So I like to just kind of stick to the middle, and you're just gonna wet it down with some water. So I'm gonna put it down. You don't need a whole lot. You don't need like puddles or anything, but just enough that there's some water so that when you put that ink down, it has somewhere to spread and kind of smear together. All right, we're gonna start with the lightest color first, which is the Balmy Blue. And you're just gonna make little dots all over, and you can kind of see that color's already moving with the water. Okay, and then we're gonna do the Pacific Point. This one is just to kind of brighten it up, to kind of make it so it's not so muddy, because we're gonna put some other colors in. But the Pacific Point just brightens it up nicely. Alrighty, and then lastly, we're gonna do the Night of Navy. This one you wanna be extra careful with. You don't need a whole lot of this one because it is super dark and it will make it really, really hard to see anything if you do too much. All right, and then we're gonna put the paint in. So you're gonna shake it up. And then I am just using a paintbrush to pull this out of here. And you're gonna do the same thing. You're just making little dots in there. Just keep in mind, if you get ink on your paintbrush or whatever you're using, clean it off before you put it back in the container, or you will have colored paint in all of your future projects. All right, so now that that's on there, we're going to get our paper ready. So like I said, we're using the Shimmer White paper, and I like to have a little bit of white space. So like on this one, for example, there's all this white in here. It's not completely colored. So if you put water all over your paper, it is going to spread the water and the color everywhere, and you'll get something that looks a lot like this. So there's not a whole lot of white. It's still really, really pretty, but it can be a little overpowering depending on what your project is going to be. So I'm just going to do right in the middle with my paintbrush. Kind of go about where I want the color to be. It's still going to move, and we really can't control it all the way, but if there's water, that's where it's going to go the most. So you're going to flip it over, water side down, and put it on there, and you're going to give it a little bit of a squish. You're going to see sometimes it's going to squish out the sides. It's okay. As long as you're on a surface, that's okay to get wet, and I wouldn't work on top of other projects or anything. All right, and then you're just going to squish up the saran wrap, because it's going to give you those cool geometric designs. And if you see, sometimes it kind of pops back up, that saran wrap. So if you have some washi tape, you can kind of tape the saran wrap where you like it, and that way you kind of keep that design and that shape. Okay, and then you're going to just set this aside. I like to put it on like a paper plate. So if you go on a paper plate, and then I'm going to tape the edges down, and that way it's not as wrinkled. Because it's wet paper, it is going to roll a little bit. When you go to attach it to the card and you're using your adhesive, it'll hold it down. But this just kind of helps it dry a little bit flatter
picture you going on the paper.
Okay, so now this guy needs to sit and dry for a little while, at least an hour. You can rush it a little bit and use your heating tool or a blow dryer, but it really needs that time to kind of sit and marinate and let all of those colors kind of mix together and blend. So we're gonna do it one more time. This time I'm gonna show you with the watercolor paper because it does give it a little bit something different. So again, we're gonna start with our Saran Wrap. We're gonna get it wet. If you don't have a paintbrush and you happen to have one of those Stampin' Spritz misters, that's perfect for this. I just didn't have one. And I like to have a little more control, a little bit of control freak. All right, so then we're gonna put our ink back on there again. Balmy Blue first. Pacific Point. And Knight of Navy. Oops, that was a big dot. If you do like what I just did where you got a real, real big dot, you just take your paintbrush and just kind of smear it a little bit and you'll kind of move it on your Saran Wrap a little. And that way, it's not all globbed up in one spot. All right, and then your paint. I'm gonna drop it in there. Oh, that one got a big drop. I just like the way this paint interacts with the Saran Wrap. It gets those really cool edges and it makes some really neat designs. Alrighty, so then this one we're gonna use the watercolor paper. So you're gonna do the same thing. You're gonna get your watercolor paper wet where you want it to be. And you're gonna notice if you use the watercolor paper, it's going to hold the water on the top of the surface a little bit more than the shimmer white paper does. And that's just because that's what watercolor paper is designed to do. It sits on top so that the colors can interact. All right, and then the same thing. You're gonna flip it upside down, water side on your Saran Wrap. Ooh, we got a good bubble there. And then you're gonna flip them over and smush. Crinkle them up. And we're gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna tape this one down if I can find the edge. There it is. Just so that it keeps, whoops. I like having all those extra wrinkles in there. I think it looks really cool. And that way we don't lose too many of them when it moves around. And as it dries, that Saran Wrap will kind of release from the paper and it gets looser. This one's gonna be really pretty. That glob of Knight of Navy blue is gonna be really pretty on there. Okay, so then the same thing, you're just gonna stick him on a paper plate. Here we go. And I'm just gonna tape them down too. It just helps it dry a little bit flatter. The watercolor paper is thicker, so you can't really hold him down too much. You just have to make sure you're using a really strong glue. I like my Tombow. To hold it down, just because it's a little more permanent than the snail. Alrighty, so I'm gonna set those guys aside. Okay, so fast forward, everything is now completely dry. It's been air drying for about 2 hours now, and it is ready to be assembled and for projects to be completed. So this is the one that we did on the shimmer white paper. You can see that the colors and the water really soak deep into the paper, so you're left with still plenty of background color and texture, but it's definitely not as bright and bold as the watercolor paper, where it's just really, really saturated with all that color because it's sitting on the surface. And my cat is shredding paper in my craft room. That's never a good sound. She is a bad kitty sometimes. So anyway, so these are, it's just, I thought it was cool for you guys to see the difference between doing it on the shimmer white paper and then the watercolor paper. It's just two different effects using the same technique, and you just really get different types of projects. So other than that, you guys have a happy and safe rest of your 4th of July, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye!